My fellow humans, I bid you welcome. Have you ever thought, damn, I really wish I could murder someone with this? Well, I did, but my empirical testing has shown that toilet paper is not really suitable to be turned into a weapon. Or is it? Let me tell you a story. It's October 1914, and a distinguished English gentleman named Geoffrey Pyke decides to get into Germany with a fake passport to work as a war journalist.
That is indeed a brilliant idea!
Petrinkel direkt in den Knast!
Blimey, I found myself in quite a pickle.
Even the most esteemed gentleman would be driven insane by spending more than 2 months in Germany, and thus our friend Geoffrey started to have a few screws loose in his brain.
Freaky, I reckon I could escape, run through the Netherlands, cross the Channel, and return to my beloved England, where I could build a giant warship made of ice. Marvelous plan.
Wow, that is so incredibly stupid. Spoiler, he did not build a giant warship made of ice. However, 20 years later...
Mr. Pyke, have you read the news? We are once again at war with Germany.
Goodness gracious. Nonetheless, that is quite fortunate indeed. May I interest you in a giant warship made of ice?
And thus, Project Habakkuk was born. The mad lad wanted to create not only a ship, but a colossal floating island that could act as an aircraft carrier. Ah, genius, isn't it? You can admire the dedication to deranged ideas.
What was the topic of this video again?
Ah, right, toilet paper! If you want to build a military vessel out of ice, you can't just use normal ice. Oh, no, you have to use pykrete, the special ice invented for the occasion by Mr. Pyke himself.
Except he didn't even invent it, he just took the credit and named it after himself. Classic Englishman move.
Let me get this straight. You want to build a humongous aircraft carrier with ice and sawdust?
That is correct, sir.
Wow,
that is so incredibly stupid.
Speaking of stupid, let's make pykrete! In theory, it should be 14% wood pulp mixed with 86% ice. Freeze to minus 15 degrees Celsius. In practice, we'll just eyeball it and ignore the scientific papers, like we always do, and complain when stuff doesn't work out. We will need a freezer,
some toilet paper,
wall clamps,
a stick, a mold, and a lot of good old science.
My plan is to make a sub-zero mace for blunt damage and a small pointy dagger for close combat and stealth kills.
Also, a murder weapon that melts and disappears might be quite convenient in certain specific situations.
I'm not saying you should try it, but, you know, just throwing the idea out there in case there are some writers listening. Or serial kill.
Step 1. Dunk the entire roll in water, squeeze out the excess and freeze it. Step 2. Fill the mold with paper and water, compress it and leave it in the freezer for a week.
1 week later, I could do all the shitty acting and YouTuber face like, wow, oh my god, let's unbox, but no, you know I'm impatient and I actually took a peek at the result because I was curious. And it looks pretty nice.
It's rock hard! I feel like I could totally murder someone with this! Isn't that exciting?
And we also have... the knife! The edge needs some refining, but I have to be quick before this melts. It's actually surprising how well it keeps the temperature. It melts much, much slower than normal ice. And...
it's burning my hands even through the gloves.
We have our weapons, so let's smash stuff!
Indoors, because my neighbors are weird and make me uncomfortable.
This is a chunky knife with the worst possible blade geometry, so I don't expect it to be good at chopping.
I would say almost usable.
stabbing! Ha! Ha! It's starting to melt, so not that impressive. Still, I would not like to be hit by that. And I'm covered in apple juice.
Ah, let's get out the big guns. I mounted the head on a wooden shaft and made this axe, hammer, club, mace thing. It really awakens something in my caveman brain. I have a coconut as a human skull analog, and I really hope it doesn't break or I'm going to make a mess and deeply regret shooting this video. Let's see. Oh no. It's breaking already. Yep. Ah. Yep, it's coconut. All right. I wonder if I can even break this thing. Ah, let's see. I am very happy about this. A little less happy about, you know, this, but it's fine. Let's do some Saturday evening cleaning. Yay!
Well, that's a really nice toy you have over there. I'm quite certain the old one will find it truly amusing.
The old one already has my flamethrower pumpkin and my temple missiles. Isn't that enough?
Oh, you know how he is. Sometimes he can get a bit greedy.
Of course. Well. Looks like it works. Greetings! If you haven't already, I would advise liking and subscribing, you little rascals. You have my sincerest gratitude for enjoying this here piece of media, and as always, take care.